everybody, welcome to the Mastery Lesson, and today we're going to look at a horse that has a little bit of a girthing issue. Now, I don't think it's anything really serious and bad, but some of you probably come across this where your horses are just kind of a little unsettled about it, you know, not really agreeable. So Lillan, who rides with me every day and has been for about, I don't know,
six months
now, yeah. Decided that she would confess to this on camera so that we could all learn something about it. So Lillan, tell me a little bit about the issue that you have.
Well, I just feel like if I ask her to be really obedient, then she saddles really nicely. And that's kind of a general theme with us. She's a right brain extrovert. If I ask for a lot of obedience, she says yes, but sometimes I feel like I can still be forcing her at phase one. So when I look like at saddling in compared to like my mounting or different things like that, it just feels like it's quite a bit weaker. She's not really involved, not really like, how can I help you saddle?
Doesn't even really tolerate it.
Yeah, and sometimes okay. It gets to the point where she actually pins her ears and really doesn't want to be involved.
Okay. Well, why don't you show me what you got going?
Okay.
And then let me see how I can help you.
Sounds good.
Okay.
Come here, sleepy.
Now, of course, sometimes horses have saddling issues because, you know, the saddle is really uncomfortable, it's tight, pinches them, that kind of thing. But with Parelli saddles, we don't have that issue. Fairly good today.
Pretty good. Still just like a little bit with the head, and she kind of feels like she's thinking about walking off a little bit.
Yeah, okay.
But yeah, that's really pretty nice. Usually she blocks me a little bit more with her nose.
Okay, there we go.
So that's usually about as extreme as it gets.
Yep.
Sometimes she tends to block me with her nose. And like I said, if I sort of say like that,
yeah,
that's all it takes with her.
Yeah.
But she goes, all right, I get it.
Yeah, but you can see it, like there's tension about her. And how bad does it get? Like, what's the worst that she's ever done?
Well, before Parelli, she used to turn around and bite me.
Okay.
but since, you know, since playing with the program and stuff, the most is like a head pin and a turn.
Okay.
It doesn't get, and like I said, usually like she does that a lot. Like I
blocks you.
Yeah, I'm going to that side to tighten the girth, and she plays that game.
Okay.
And like she can read my intention.
Yes.
Like it's not, that's not a fluke. She, you know, so
yeah.
That's kind of where it is. That it just feels like it's not a lot of involvement or acceptance and
okay. Sort of. And when you first started using Parelli, she then improved because you warmed her up 7 games, all that kind of thing. But it's never really gotten any better than that.
Exactly. That's
okay.
Really about as good as it's gotten.
And, okay. Yeah. Now what happens if if you rub her around the girth area, does she worry about that?
Doesn't seem to too much. Again,
okay.
I feel when you said it, it sort of struck me that maybe there's a little bit more tolerance there than actual acceptance. But it feels pretty solid for the most
okay.
part.
Well, let's take the saddle off and then go through a few tests, okay? Because sometimes you don't always know what it is that's causing it. And if we can just check, you know, a lot of different things and by a process of deduction go, okay, it's not that, what is it really about?
Okay.
Okay. And some horses are, you know, some horsenalities are more worried about things like the right brain, usually right brain horses, when they have saddling or girthing issues, it's because they don't trust and they feel really worried. Right brain introverts, they tend to be very claustrophobic, so they are naturally girthy kind of horses, and so you just got to go really slow with them. Left brain horses, it's more of like, I don't want you doing anything to me. And so once the relationship improves, usually that's gone.
Yeah.
Right. Or if a horse has got really bad memories about you know, being saddled rudely and girth too tight, you know, even before we got them, then often they have that association when we put the saddle on and start to, you know, to girth up.
Yeah.
And so then usually what cures that is just, here, have a carrot.
Yeah.
Now, that may even be something that helps her, right?
Okay.
Is to, you know, when she puts her ears back, just give her a cookie.
Okay.
And a lot of people go, oh, what, isn't that teaching them to, you know, put their ears back? It's like, no, because this is not training them to do that. It's more about changing their perception of the whole thing.
Got it.
So show me just rubbing her around her girth area. And let me just watch her face. And And now if you were to push on her girth with your hand, like as if you were lifting her body a little bit. Okay, that doesn't really even bother her. And now put your arms around her as much as you can. Kind of squeeze her a little bit. Okay, yeah. So it's more about that. Now if you push on one side without her moving her feet, does she do it? No, put your arm over and push on the same side, on this side. No, okay, now put both hands, squeeze them together. Okay, so she doesn't like that constriction.
And that's her, like the head dropping thing, that's her typical going
override,
into, yeah.
Override my emotions.
Yeah, yeah, tolerance place, like, oh, I know I'm supposed to be acting like a partner, and yeah, she has that really strong.
Yeah. Okay, so now what I want you to do, like, because it's a reaction to pressure, mm-hmm, right? And do it just a little further down, like you did that up where the girth, where she would feel the girth. Just start at the girth and then go back one hand breadth and use the same kind of pressure. Okay, so there's a reaction. Less reaction. Yeah, nothing. And now go back up to that area. Yeah. Okay. So that's where the issue is now. Now try a little higher.
Like not reaching underneath so far?
Yeah. Just go like a hand's breadth higher. 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 And then back lower again. Okay, so it's right there. And what's really interesting is that, you know, if you touch it with just one, it's like, no, that's not a problem. So there is an association with the pressure on both sides, mm, and we don't really know what it could be. It could be, you know, that she feels a little claustrophobic. It could be that she feels uncomfortable. I would doubt there's pain.
Yeah.
Because if there was, she'd react to, you know, even just pushing it on one side.
Yeah.
And I'm probably doing five times what you did.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Okay. All right. So now let's put the rope around her middle. I mean, like around that spot, around the girth area. Okay, so then just kind of cross them like that so that you can slowly tighten it. Now, before you tighten it, you want to just take a little bit of the slack out of your rope, because if for any reason that she got mad and wanted to kick or anything like that, that you could bring her head to you, which takes the hindquarters away.
Okay. Right?
So just slowly tighten it. Keep tightening it till we get a reaction. And when we get the reaction, stay there. Don't back off. Keep going tighter. Okay, now stay there and let her just think her way through it. And when you see a positive change, like she lowers her head or blinks her eyes, or, you know, actually does a little bit more than blinking, she lowers her head. Because right now she's like pretending nothing exists.
Right? Yeah.
Lowers her head or breathes. Breathes out. We're just going to stay with that pressure there and wait for the relaxation. So in this situation, we're looking for the moment she starts to respond. We're not taking it so high that she would get really bothered. Right? So there she took a bit of a breath. But she almost stops breathing. So she gets kind of a little bit introverted about it.
Yeah.
So we'll just wait. She's getting a little bit more conscious here and there. And at this point, it's usually tempting to go, let's just make it a little tighter to speed up the process, but that's not the idea.
I can see her lips quivering a
yes.
little bit too.
Ooh, see, then her ears went back. She kind of had a negative thought about it.
It was interesting.
Now release it. So even though she looked at something, let's just reward it that she wasn't thinking about that. Okay? And now slowly tighten it up again. And anywhere that she shows a reaction, stop right at that point. And we're looking for the littlest reaction, like negative reaction. And then let me know if you've gotten tighter at this point than where you were before.
Feels like she's kind of tuning me out. It's about as tight as I can go.
Okay. Just stay like that now. But she didn't react like the last one.
Mm-mm.
So sometimes, you know, when you're girthing up, even if you go really slowly, but you're still making progress, and, you know, they have a reaction and we keep going, even if we're being gentle, that can really be what bothers them.
Yeah.
Right? Okay, so let's just wait for a positive change. She swallowed then.
Yeah.
On the celebration DVD that we have from the Horse and Allergy Celebration in England last year, we had a very similar thing with a horse about mounting. And so I just had her put her foot up and then down. Every time there was a reaction, she went away. Reaction went away until finally she could mount the horse with no negative reaction at all. So I think we're and he was a left brain horse.
Mm.
But he, you know, he'd gone pretty right brain introvert because, you know, he was fairly damaged before she got him. So I think we're probably going to do the same thing.
Her breathing start. I can feel her breathing a little bit more now.
Yeah. So if you're not going to get any kind of cramp in your arms, if we can stay like that till she has a positive change, then we'll move to the saddle.
Okay.
But yeah, I can see her breathing now. It's quite different. She's not as shut down in her expression.
Shall I take that?
Nope.
Nope. Okay.
Let's wait for a little more now.
Yep.
Good. So she's making adjustments in her body.
I just released on that, sorry.
Okay, oh, good.
I thought your good was a cue for a release.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, that's all right.
I would have hung in there a little bit longer, just because I think we would get the
licking
of lips, right? Okay. So that would be ideal, but let's not go on with it anymore.
All right.
Because I think now we can achieve the same thing with the saddle.
Okay.
So now when you saddle her, here's what you're going to do. At any stage of the saddling process, if you notice a little brace in her, just stop and wait.
Okay.
Okay. So even if she goes to like block you going in there, stop and wait.
Okay.
Watch her, watch her.
That felt a lot better than last time.
Good.
Do you remember last time she kind of went head up and even moved off a little bit?
Yeah.
I felt a lot better.
Good. Now wait right there. You can relax. You don't have to keep your hands there. Just wait. So it's, you know, when you're kind of just starting, very good.
That's okay, big for her, huh?
Yeah, that's the change that we're looking for her to go.
It's like she listened to me.
Yes.
From her perspective, she kind of went.
Yes.
Hmm.
Exactly. She says, I was trying to say something and you just kept going.
Yeah.
Even if it's gentle and you keep going, the horse just feels disrespected. Right?
Yeah. Because that's often a place, especially when I've ridden her in a performer, that like readjust place is often a place, you know, and you kind of pull the pad up and readjust the saddle.
And she's like,
argh. Yeah, that's often a place she gets a little bit bracy.
Yeah. Good. Okay. Carry on. Rubber first as you go in. Yep. And just keep observing her. It's great. Still licking her lips more. I think that was a fly that she did that to. Now, instead of walking around her like that, put your hand under her jaw and just get permission to change sides. Good. Now, I like what you're doing there, that you're not just pulling her over.
Just waiting.
Yes.
Yeah.
Asking for her to yield, but the yield for her to be her idea.
Yeah. Kind of went away again there. Yeah. And that's like for where her porcupine game's at, that's quite a bit of pressure for us.
Yeah, because training's not the problem.
Yeah.
It's now opinion.
Yeah.
Right? And it, well, and more than that, it's permission.
Yeah.
She's like, you know, I'm tolerating it kind of, but I haven't really given you permission to do that.
Yeah.
So, you know, what I started saying before is that, you know, in the earlier levels, you're just glad that horses aren't biting you anymore or they're standing still. But now as you get into higher levels, you know, it really pays off to go, if I notice every little thing that my horse is trying to tell me, that's going to take the relationship to a whole new level. And it may only be today that you have to do this much.
Yeah.
Tomorrow it'll be half as much. Yeah. The next day it'll be half that again. Super. Yeah, I would have taken her all the way then. Just okay. Going, good, away you go. Yep, good. That was already easier. And even a little bit left brain there.
Yeah.
Go, good.
Loads better.
Good.
Yeah.
Now stop. You don't even have to back off. Like you could just stop and stand comfortable next to her. So stopping is still retreat.
Okay.
With horses that have a lot of trouble, then yes, I would step away. But for her now, it's just nuances.
Yeah.
Now what we're waiting for is permission. And I think, you know, for people watching, sometimes this is like grass growing. People go, oh, I don't have time to do this.
Yeah.
It's like, but you have time for your horse to be mad at you every time you saddle.
Totally.
And for things never to get better.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, a lot of people watching this are going to go, wow, I'm going to take a little bit more care about when I saddle.
Yeah.
And it's a little bit like, you know, somebody putting your clothes on you.
Yeah.
Right? She just stuck her ears back a couple of times then, you know. It was like, oh, just had some bad thoughts. And then she went, oh, nothing's happening.
Yeah.
But, you know, if somebody was going to put your clothes on you and they just didn't care, like if it was uncomfortable or awkward for you and you kind of made a face or said something, but they kept going, you'd kind of lose respect for them.
Yeah, definitely.
Like even if it's not something that's hurting you, it's just, hey,
yeah. You
know, take it easy.
It's definitely one of those things where you realize you've had the time to do it wrong over and over again.
Yep. Yeah. And do you always cinch on the right side or do you sometimes change it around?
Change it around.
Okay, good. Because that would be another thing. It's like, you know, when horses, most people saddle and cinch from the left.
Mm.
And so then sometimes just changing it up and going, well, we'll do it on the right today and then okay. We'll do it on the left tomorrow. And sometimes that really helps. So it's just checking.
Funny that little reaction.
Yeah, it's almost like she goes to turn loose and then she goes, no, I can't.
Yeah.
Yep. So we'll just wait. So this is a lot like strategies for right brain introverts, because that's actually how she's behaving, even though she's, it's good. She'll probably lick her lips. Yep. I see that a lot. A horse will rub its nose on its leg and then lick its lips.
Yeah.
Okay, and now rub her. And keep watching her. Don't sneak. Just go about it. Just go about it, and if you see something, just stop. Stop and let go. Yep. And now we'll wait. So right now, her brain's got to be going, this is really different. It's hard to stay mad.
Yeah.
Like her ears went back, then they went forward, and then she went, oh no, I kind of uncomfortable about this. All right, so we're really changing a mental pattern here
for
her.
Yeah, definitely.
Good job. But you want to be careful that you're not now going really sneaky slowly.
Okay.
All right?
Yep.
That you're just going about your business, but you're being gentle and keeping track of what her opinion is.
Cool. So interesting.
Good. Now, may not be licking lips again, but we're just looking for a positive change and where she's not acting so sleepy.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that the sleepy is pretty much just introversion?
Yeah, that's introversion.
That's what I feel.
Because
like
horses,
too.
You know, they're gonna react to an emotional state one of two ways. They're gonna run
yeah.
which is usually extrovert,
yeah.
or they're going to run away inside, which is introvert. And so when you've got a horse that's as far along as she is, she overrides a lot of her old stuff, you know, yeah. where she used to be so challenging.
Yeah.
So now she goes, oh, I know, I've got to try and get through this. And so she does that. And then what she shows is a little bit of an introverted state.
Definitely.
And so in that moment, even though she's a right brain extrovert, you go, that's an introverted behavior. So I'm going to now treat her like an introvert, yeah. even though innately she's not that.
Yeah.
So that's where often we talk about address the horse that shows up.
Totally.
Right? So the extrovert suddenly showed up introvert. It's like, ooh, I better change my strategy for
yeah.
that. Just take your shoulders a little away from her. I was going to say, don't move your feet or anything, but just kind of do that. You just want to, you know, make sure that, like, even mentally, just be observing her out the corner of your eye, but not thinking about her.
Okay.
Because sometimes even just waiting and watching for the response is pressure.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. There's a nice change in her ears.
Okay.
Right?
Yep.
And a little bit more of a conscious blink.
Yeah.
Right? So now just reach up and rub her. Rub, 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 like an extrovert a little bit. There you go. Okay. So right there, you're rubbing the core pony.
Okay.
Okay.
Kind of helping her come out of it a little bit almost?
Well, yeah, it's just you're really... communicating with her.
Okay.
Okay. So good. Rub, 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 rub. Good. So now there's some nice changes, kind of a softening in her eye. Because the whole time you got to go, it's not about the saddle. She's right. blaming you for something, right? Good. Nice. Okay. Now go to reach under, slide your hand all the way under her. Yep. You're good. You're good. And stop there and hold it.
That was interesting in a way. She almost told us more that time, didn't she?
Yep.
Since you're listening, I'll tell you how I really feel.
Yes. And then when she changes, we're going to go to the next step. We're not going to retreat.
Okay.
So our pausing is the same as retreat
okay.
in this situation. So there you can see she's all shut down again.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh, I'm not in this world. That was a good breathe.
Yeah.
Took a big breath. So I'm really hoping that this will be the one where she licks her lips.
Okay.
Just you stay relaxed. Whatever you need to do to feel comfortable is fine. Don't change the pressure of the girth.
Okay.
Yep, cocking your leg is good. Feels more relaxed.
I can feel the emotion in me at what I've busted through a little bit.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Just feeling like what I've kind of pushed through, you know?
Yeah. You know, again, this is kind of a high level of horsemanship. You know, being tuned in at that level of how a horse feels. Like, I don't expect that of anybody under level 3. But I think by level 4, you can start, you know, being way more conscious about the little things. How you read your horse and what the appropriate response is. And it's funny how she has little flashbacks and her ears get tight.
Yeah.
She thinks about it and it's like, yeah. And then she goes, oh, nothing's happening.
Her breathing's changing now,
yep.
big time.
But I think this is fascinating from, like, again, watching the way her blinking changes or her, you know, how much her ears are moving. That tells you about brain activity, you know, or emotional activity, one or the other, or both.
Mm.
And so through that, you just go, I'm just going to wait until you can process that, because that's what she's doing.
Yeah.
She's just processing everything. And so when you give them time to think, you know, like the horses that need this, they need the time to think and process, especially when it's emotional.
Yeah.
Then that's where you make the big changes.
Totally. Her breathing's so different now.
Yeah. What's different about it?
I can feel like the whole girth is moving in my hand as she breathes.
Yeah, so she's probably been holding her breath every time she gets cinched.
Yeah.
It's good. I love it when I see her kind of squeeze her eyes in a blink. That's a big change.
And are you still thinking, like, continue on when she licks?
Yep.
Or?
Okay. Yep. But we'll let her do all the licking.
Okay.
Licking and chewing.
Okay.
And then we'll go to the next step, and you might only get half an inch further.
Okay.
You might only just get to pick up the strap.
Yeah.
And then have to wait again. But what we're going to get out of this is a big change, big turn loose. So, you know, often people ask me, you know, how can you be this patient? It's because I love watching horses learn, and I love helping them get over their issues.
Yeah.
And time stands still for me.
Yeah.
You know, just get totally in the moment. I don't care how long this takes. And if you're going to do this and you think it might take a while, make sure you're in a situation where you don't have to rush and go, oh, now I've got to get to work, or, you know, go pick up somebody or whatever. It's like, make sure you've got the time to play with something like this to make a big breakthrough.
Her lips are quivering so much.
Yeah. It's interesting watching the muscles around her ears. You know, like, that's where I can see the biggest change right now, is that there's like a softening around her ears. And we also haven't really seen much tension in her neck like we did before.
Yeah, definitely.
But again, you know, you can't go back to just blowing through everything tomorrow when you saddle her.
Yeah.
You have to prove to her that you're going to wait for permission at each step. And once she believes you, then it's over. But you still always saddle that way.
Yeah.
You would never go, okay, now I can, you know, just saddle however I want.
Yeah.
It becomes just a positive habit. You know, this is how a horseman would do it.
Right.
You know, I love those stories that Pat tells about, you know, old wise horsemen that, you know, they're watching you get your horse ready, and they'll watch how you handle the rope, and they'll watch how you saddle a horse. And then they'll give you the nod of like, you're pretty good around horses.
Mm.
It's not the riding so much as it is how tuned into to the horse you are.
Yeah, completely.
Okay, that's nice.
There's a swallow.
Good, she just went. So you could do something now, like just pick up the girth strap in your other hand and just see if that does anything. Good. And now progress. Watch her from the corner of your eye rather than staring at her. Really good. Really good. And you're just going to put it in a hole where you don't have to tighten it, where it's like just right there. Don't be sneaky. Just get it done smoothly. That was pretty good. Okay, now just turn your back on her and just stay there. And now let's watch her process this, because this is going to be mind-blowing for her. She's like, I have never been saddled like this, right? And so all my negative patterns that I'm in have just been interrupted.
Yeah.
Okay? So now this is big processing for her.
Big processing for me too.
Yeah. Yeah. So, you know, sometimes, like watching horses, you know you need to go a lot faster.
Yeah.
Like often with left brain extroverts, you have to saddle 10 times faster or brush them 10 times faster, because they get cranky when you're kind of being nice and slow, because they're thinking, I want to play, and, you know, now we're not playing, I'm going to be evil to you. And so you've got to kind of flood their brain with like lots of information.
Yeah.
So usually with left brain extroverts that are difficult to saddle, I just go way faster.
Yeah.
Left brain introverts, give them a carrot.
Yeah.
You know, when they're cranky about it.
Yeah.
Right brain introverts, usually it's a lot like this.
Yeah.
And right brain extroverts, it can be kind of fast and smooth, or if they go to this state, then you would do this.
Yeah.
So again, you just go, what are all these different strategies that I might have to use? And then I just be appropriate.
Yeah.
And so still lots of processing. Now, we think about what to do next. What you would not do is go in and tighten it one more time.
Mm.
I would move her a couple of steps,
mm-hmm.
and then tighten it.
Okay.
Okay, and just go one hole.
Okay.
So I'd like to see her come out of that state right now. So tell me what's been interesting for you so far in doing this.
Definitely I've learned a lot about what sort of releases. Like you talk specifically in Game of Contact, I remember, about matching the release to the amount of try.
Yeah.
And I sort of felt like that kind of resonated. It's like when she really tried to be present and make a change, we really gave her a big release. And then when she was kind of like trying a little bit, that was when you sort of said, just hold or go to the next step. And just that balance of trying to be progressive without without blowing her up when she's in this more RBI place,
yeah.
you know, with really respecting her opinion.
Yeah, great.
And it's cool, like I think the biggest thing I realize now that I felt was missing is my saddling wasn't a conversation.
Oh,
right?
That's huge.
Yeah, so that's been the biggest thing. Like now, even if there's some, oh, I blew through that, or this is a negative pattern, it's like, well, at least we're having a conversation about it.
Yes,
yeah.
That's a really good way to put it.
So.
Because a lot of the time you think about, you know, how horses are often saddled is in cross ties.
Mm.
And, you know, no matter how much opinion the horse shows, people could just go ahead and saddle and get the job done.
Yeah.
But, you know, we're not putting a saddle on a motorbike.
Right.
You know, this is a living, breathing, thinking, feeling animal. And especially in our program where we talk about putting the relationship first, this is the kind of nuances that you get to.
Yeah.
Right.
Definitely.
And again, it's, you know, it's a level of savvy. I don't expect people who are just starting to do this.
Yeah.
But as you're striving for that level of excellence, 4, 5, 6,
yeah.
now it becomes a critical piece of moving
Definitely.
Forward. And sometimes like you can just do this and now your whole riding experience is different.
I bet it is. Yeah.
Yeah. So we were going to next make a, do a lesson on impulsiveness. We may have cured it right here.
I know. Isn't
we'll
that
see.
Interesting, yeah. Lots of shifting her weight too.
Yep.
Yeah.
And usually when they're walking forward, that's them saying, I need to get out of here.
Yeah.
Like that's the run instinct, the predator flight thing.
Mm.
Even though they're kind of doing it in slow motion.
Okay.
It's them reacting to pressure and going, I need to leave.
Yeah.
So it's great she hasn't felt the need to leave.
Yeah.
Right? So you've just stayed on this side of trouble.
Definitely.
And you will never saddle the same way again.
No.
Any horse.
That's for sure.
Any horse. You will have that sensitivity to it. And it doesn't mean you go slow and sneaky. You try to really look at what's the horsenality.
Yeah.
You know, and then what kind of pace should I use? And I'm always smooth and asking permission. And the moment I feel no permission,
yeah.
stop there.
Yeah.
And just wait. Sometimes if they're really difficult, retreat.
Mm.
So again, it's like what you were saying is, you know, how much release do I give?
Yeah.
Sometimes just pausing is enough. Mm. So next time she makes a little bit of a change, I want you to rub her again on her neck. You know, kind of rub the extrovert in her.
Cool.
Like, you know, her core horsenality. Because if you rub her like a right brain introvert, usually with a right brain introvert, don't even touch them.
Yeah.
Right? Because it's like, that's
yeah,
too much.
Pressure.
Yeah, so go in and just really put your heart in your hand and let her feel your heart and, you know, and rub her with some intention.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
So we'll just wait for that moment. But her ears are way softer. She's still kind of half out of it with her eyes.
Yeah.
But, you know, the big prize would be, but it may not be until right at the end of the process
yeah.
that, you know, that'll
yeah.
happen. Now, when you go to draw her to you after you've petted her, what I want you to do is step back and just comb the rope and get her to just walk a couple of steps to you, then rub her, go to the saddle, and continue to the next hole.
Okay.
And every time we tighten the saddle, we're going to do that.
Yeah.
Now, Pat talks about moving a horse, you know, with 3 cinchings.
Yeah.
Your saddle's not tight enough to go move.
Yeah.
And she actually doesn't need that because
yeah.
you're not in that place where, you know, bucking and all of that is an issue. It's more
yeah.
really subtle stuff.
Yeah.
So you just move their feet a couple of steps, And then after you've got it, that was interesting. Look, she's stretching. Mm-hmm. Very good, yeah. All those things are like really important things to read.
take that.
And so then once you've got it pretty well as firm as you need it,
okay,
then you can go and play and just make sure everything's safe before you get on.
Okay.
Right? So it's just another way to go, well, how would I do this at this level with this kind of issue?
Cool. Just no rules, just guidelines.
Yeah.
Exactly. Should I take that as a rubbing?
Yeah, I would. I think that's a really nice change. Again, you know, we're looking for all kinds of changes. And I always try to think about it, like, how is a horse going to show me a change in mental or emotional energy? And it can be wiggling their ears, blinking their eyes, licking their lips, change in breathing, lowering their neck. She did the stretch her back legs and then cock a leg. Those are all the things, and I'll take one or three of them, or I'll go, what would be the most? Then she's licking her lips. Super, super, super. Good. So she's making progress, but she's not turned loose, right? Okay, so now walk her over this way, just back up towards me. Draw her to you. Don't be sneaky. Just like we do this every day. And now walk in there, rub her like an extrovert. If she's blocking you, wait. Okay, now walk a little closer to her and wait. Go a little bit to your left and then wait. Because we're going to give her room to put her head over this way. And when she goes to turn her head, kind of just rock your body back and then rock in.
Okay.
Pretending to be very distracted by something.
I know, interesting, isn't it? Try this tack.
See, that cinch is so loose.
Yeah.
Right? So we know it's not about the pressure. Even like pressing her, there was only that one spot. And she was like, right, that's the girth spot. And that's what I've got years of making faces about.
Yeah, okay? Definitely.
But it's more about the permission and just the whole respect side of it. Go a little closer and a little bit to your left. There you go. Try not to stare at her. Just kind of be in the way. And then it's going to be her idea where she goes, okay. It'd be interesting if she turns more and blocks you, but we'll see. Mm. Soften your jaw. Oh, how interesting. In you go. Don't be sneaky. Be real friendly. Stop. Go. Stop. Now we're going to just work with little subtleties. As soon as she changes, we're going to go again. Go. Just one ear changed. Keep going. Be real smooth. Keep going. Super. Stop and hold it. Her nostril on this side is like, left side's relaxed, right side's like, nyeh.
Which is interesting because she
doesn't. You're to blame.
Yeah, she doesn't do that very often. The little sneer, I've seen that a couple of times now.
Okay, she's about to make a change. And then we can go again.
Deeper breath there.
Mm-hmm. Okay, go. Don't be so slow. Be smooth. Oh, good. Go. Great. And now step away from her. Just come over to me. Good. So now we could speed it up. After we first, you know, made those first big impressions on her.
Yeah.
Then it was kind of like green light, red light, green light, red light, green light, red light.
Okay.
Orange light, be careful. Red or green? Green. Go.
Okay.
Okay. So then you just do that, you know, what color light have I got? And when it's green, go.
Okay.
Because sometimes, you know, we can just miss that part and then it's like, now it's even harder.
Yeah.
So that's where as you start to like really watch them out the corner of your eye.
Okay.
You know, that you can just notice the littlest things. And even up close, you can notice a change in breathing or muscle tension.
Mm.
Good. Now you're going to bring her to you again. Don't be so sneaky. Come on. Ask. Don't be afraid to ask. Yep. Good. Rub the extrovert in her. If she blocks you, go, go, go. Too sneaky.
Too sneaky.
Now, what was positive there, she didn't block you.
Yeah.
But now she's like having a little bit of an ear thing.
Yeah.
But she's licking her lips. Keep rubbing her. Keep rubbing her. She's like, oh, this is really hard. I'm like licking my lips and I'm trying to be upset and I can't do both. There, now stop. Good.
Almost like I forgot to block you and now I'm mad about it.
Yeah. Okay. Now just go in and you're going to go another hole. And red light, hold. Green light. It's just a change in the ears. Red light. Green light. Red light. Ah, big sigh.
Yeah.
So she's like, oh, you're listening to me. Go ahead. That's a green light. Red light. Hold.
Interesting as she goes the other way.
I was just going to say that before like, she kind of looks at you.
Yeah.
Now it's almost like I'm having trouble being mad at you.
Yeah.
Right?
Interesting.
Licked her lips. Very good. Just walk away now. Put that in its hole. Walk away. Come over to me. Super. Super, super, super. Okay, so your timing then with the red and green lights was really good.
You were saying it. Well, that helped.
That's right. I was saying that for the camera, so you couldn't hear it.
Oh, okay.
Super. Okay, we're going to wait just for a little change again. And then we're going to go in again.
Okay.
All right, same thing. Good. Licking her lips. This is really good. Okay, walk in softly but surely. Friendly, yes. Super, no blocking. Wait with her a little while, wait, because she's going, you're going to go near my girth.
Yeah.
Rub her, rub her, rub her. Just you convince her this is about her, not about the saddle. Now she's even starting to yawn. Huge. Huge. Take the saddle off. Go quick, take it off, off. Yeah. She can follow you, go. Now, let's watch the behavior. Just sit down and relax. This is what she's been holding on to, is all that kind of tension and internal stress of like, ah, and it's not about the saddle. It's the fact that, you know, she was trying to tell you that she wasn't ready or whatever, or she's had bad experiences and you kept going. Even
yeah.
though you were nice about it, you kept going.
Yeah.
And so now she's going, I love Lillan. He's listening to me.
Wow.
And even that thing that you noticed where she was looking to the other side when she kind of got upset about it instead
yeah.
of at you.
Yeah.
You know, she's like, I can't blame Lillan.
Interesting.
That was awesome.
Very cool.
Yeah. She's still got a little bit of processing to do.
Yeah.
So you're going to have to saddle like that for the rest of your life. But you should do that with every horse.
Yeah.
Right. Definitely. And just go, how do I really get permission? How do I get them to, you know, to be connected with me and my toys.
Yeah.
You know, not, it's me.
Yeah.
And so, you know, it shouldn't take as long.
Yeah.
Next time, because it's just red light, green light, red light, green light.
Yeah.
And now you've kind of got the idea of like, I don't have to go red light and stop forever.
Mm.
We just did that in the beginning to prove to her that we're really serious, that we'll wait for her permission.
Wow.
Still processing.
Yeah. Those ear pins like that.
Yeah,
she's like, intense.
Oh. I've seen that a lot.
Yeah.
It's very cool.
It just proves it's not about the saddle, huh? It's not even on her, and she's having that little flashback there.
Yep. And look, still licking lips and chewing over it, and, you know, she's got a lot of processing still to do.
Yeah.
And this is where, at this point, you know, if you can just hang out with her.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of people go, oh, I'll take the halter off and be done with it.
Yeah.
But this is where it's really important, you know. It's like after you've been through it and you're hanging in there with her through that processing.
Cool.
Then they really believe you.
Yeah.
But when you go, okay, that's it, they go, oh, you don't care.
Yeah.
And maybe they think that or they don't. But I know that when you stay with them through that process, it's different.
Yeah.
Yeah, very good. So was there anything you felt was difficult to do there? Was it difficult to read her or anything?
No, I felt like she was pretty straightforward. And in a way, the thing that was neat was the, I think even if I went back and watched the beginning of this video, you know, we both kind of said, oh, it's not that bad. And then her reactions actually got more extreme as she was like, you're listening to me. I'm going to stop being obedient, like quite so obedient, and really tell you where I'm at with that.
Yeah.
So that was pretty cool. And that's been a lot of my journey since I've been riding with you, with her, is her starting to come out of that and really own some of her patterns herself, and just be more, much, much more connected.
Yeah.
As opposed to so obedient.
Yeah. And that's a big difference, isn't it? I think that's nicely said.
Yeah.
Connected versus obedient.
Yeah.
Because like you said, you know, you could tell her to stand still and you could tell her to behave herself.
Yeah.
But that's not really permission. That's,
yeah,
and compliance, isn't it?
You can't get the exuberance from that,
no,
place.
Like that's it, why it's a high level thing. It's,
yeah,
like you've got to get through that,
yeah,
to really go to the next level.
Yeah. It's, you're never going to get the exuberance if you're just saying stand still or stand up and pay attention and that, yeah, sort of a thing. So.
Yeah. Pat always says nothing means nothing.
Yeah.
Everything means something. And even if you don't know what it means, if you at least pay attention to it and go, ooh, I'm going to try to get through this, even if you don't have enough knowledge, the fact that you try, your horse will notice.
Yeah.
You know?
So was it the yawn at the end that really sort of signified to you that that was a big, big release and she just,
yep,
needed to have the whole game sort of,
yep,
be done? Cool.
Because all the other little signals, you know, with the ears softening, the licking lips or moving the lips, and,
yeah,
blinking eyes,
yep,
lowering the head, you know, what she did with her hind legs.
Yeah.
And breathing,
yep,
they're all changes that tell you that the horse is getting more calm.
Okay.
Right? But then when you go, well, what would be the big prize?
Mm.
It's a big blowout. Like, mm, these are now the next ones.
Yeah.
Big blowout, yawning,
yeah,
rolling.
Okay.
They're like, they're the top end of all the adrenaline's gone.
Okay.
Right? And especially if, like, it's been a really bad thing. Like, in fact, with my new horse, Highland, he's very afraid. He's not afraid to be saddled. He's not afraid to be mounted. He's afraid when you ask him to go.
Mm.
And so my first two sessions of riding him, I did it more by leading rein starts and following allure.
Yeah.
And just really soft. And by the third session, when I got on him and then asked him to move off, he had no problem moving off.
Mm.
He was like, he just blew out immediately, took a few steps, then wanted to roll.
Mm.
While I'm on him.
Wow.
And I'm like, ah, I don't know if we can do this. And,
yeah,
so I had to interrupt it a little bit. But what it really showed me was how much of the adrenaline he released.
Yeah. There was a horse that did that in Australia in Game of Contact.
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember you rode Chris Corbidge's horse?
Oh, yes.
And at the end of your third session, the breakthrough with the bits and stuff, she wanted to lie down and roll,
yeah,
too. Yeah.
Yeah. So, you know, like for a prey animal to lay on the ground, voluntarily,
yeah,
like without being told to lay down.
Yeah.
But for them to go, I just feel so safe now, and they lay down in front of us, like, mm, that's one of the biggest compliments.
Yeah, for sure.
Especially from a right brain horse.
Yes.
That was awesome, Lillan.
Yeah, thank you. That was huge.
Well done.
Just feeling like the conversation was just really huge for,
yeah,
us.
Yeah, it was. And now that's what you have. You have conversation and connection rather than just tolerance and obedience.
Yeah.
It wasn't even real tolerance, was it?
Yeah.
But now, you know, you just have to make sure you have enough time to saddle her every day.
Yeah.
Because it's still going to be a little longer than the end result's going to,
yeah,
be.
Yeah.
But, you know, all it is, it's kind of like patterns,
mm,
where, you know, 4 to 7 times in a row, that's usually what it takes for the horse to learn the pattern.
Okay.
Like a positive pattern or a negative pattern, right? So what you're teaching her now is a new pattern in you.
Yeah.
And so it'll take 4 to 7 times for her to believe you.
Okay.
Because if tomorrow you ignore a red light,
yeah,
she's going to go, ah, see,
game over.
Yeah, you were faking it. You, mm, really weren't. You really didn't care about me.
Cool.
Very cool. So, a lot about horse behavior in this one. You know, learning to read horses, thinking about permission, about conversation, getting that connection, and then knowing where to go from there. And I think it was great for Lillan to show us this because I'm sure, well, I know, there's a lot of horses out there, almost at any level, that have those little subtle issues. And I know at my barn, it's everything. When my horses are being saddled, I'm really particular about these kinds of things because the relationship is so important. Oh, look at that.
Oh, more yawns again.
Huge.
I know, me too. Good kid.
Do you know it was about 5 years before Siren showed me an itchy spot?
Really? It was about the same with her. Like very rarely and then very, very rare.
She's even yawning more extrovert now.
Yeah. It's hard to yawn and keep your ears pinned, huh?
And a cock leg. She's probably gonna want to roll now.
She does. Should I let her?
It's up to you.
Well, I feel like you kind of talked about it.
Yeah, because then we could say, well, that's why we got a dirty horse in this next DVD.
Yeah, take the saddle off again. I just kept going with the same process, sort of resaddled her again. And then I just got one hole where she stayed totally present and didn't pin her ears at all. And then she wanted to roll. So I took the saddle off and I'm just allowing that.
I was just about to say, what we haven't heard yet is the snort.
She's still yawning lots and... Hi! Look at those ears!
You may not have an impulsive horse after this. Huge.
Start again.
Yeah, so maybe we can film the whole saddling process. Different. Super.
Tons more connection.
locking.
I love the ear pin while she licks and chews. Last one was pretty awesome. Good girl. All right.
Well, what big changes we got to see with Damo. Isn't it interesting how as we watched her start to trust more and more, she actually went and did all the things I talked about. I forgot to mention shaking in the neck and the head actually, but she, you know, started to really change in her attitude. She looked for itchy spots, you know, wanted her to scratch her, and Lillan said that never really happens. And then of course she rolled and blew out, and that was the big prize. So take the time it takes, and it takes less time. And think about this, it's about the relationship. It's how much can you notice what your horse is trying to tell you and do the appropriate thing so that then you two can go on and have the relationship of your dreams, both of your dreams. See you next mastery lesson.